At this point in our story, Rick Nelson is leading a charmed but difficult life. He's still a teenage idol, but he's also trying to be a husband and father. And at the same time, he's still part of his squeaky clean family's phenomenally successful television show. For a while, his popularity rivals that of Elvis, but in the early 1960s, a slow tumble from the glory days begins.
Who's rushing where angels could have tread?
In late 1963, early 1964, Top 40 Radio is playing Rick Nelson's last two hits from his teen idol days. For You, and at Ozzy's suggestion, a remake of an old Glenn Miller song, Fools Rush In.
People moved on, and, people moved away from Elvis eventually, too.
Television's changing, too. What once was in is suddenly passé.
We almost forgot to kiss Mom goodbye. Good night.
That's not funny.
Much less acceptable for us to see Dave and Ricky still living at home after they were already pretty much grown up. And I think that the writing was pretty much on the wall.
And just as color TV replaces black and white, the show is canceled. In January 1966, after 435 episodes, ABC replaces Ozzy and Harriet with Batman and Robin. Rick Nelson is out of hits and off the air. But strangely, it's not all bad.
Rick secretly was kind of relieved. He felt bad for his father. But that was around the time that Rick told his father, and it was very hard for him, it took him probably years to work up the courage, that he wanted to control his music totally.
The following year, Chris gives birth to twins, Matthew and Gunnar. And around this time, he writes a song about his kids. Tracy calls it...
Tracy, come out and play. Red light, green light, and I'll be it today, cause it's a...
My father had a music room right below my bedroom. And a lot of times, he would play just all night long. And the piano behind me is his piano. But I used to fall asleep a lot of the time with my blanket lying on the floor, listening to the music come up through the wood.
Up the street, around the square, Gunnar and Matthew are already there.
And it's a new sound that Rick is playing with.
When he was 28 and 9, suddenly he discovers Bob Dylan.
My love, she laughs like the flowers. Valentine's can't buy her.
This music had an equally profound impact on him. And he started writing his own songs.
Mr. Rick Nelson.
His new group, the Stone Canyon Band, clicks and starts touring with its jazzed up country sound.
Yes, it's been, I'm telling you, back to me, and I'm hoping that you come back to me.
Is a comeback possible? For Elvis, seen here in his legendary 1968 NBC special, it's already happening.
Burning brighter somewhere.
Can Rick do the same? In 1971, eager to promote his latest album, he appears at Madison Square Garden for a rock and roll revival. First, he sings some old favorites. But trouble erupts when he sings some newer tunes.
He was the only act on the bill that had long hair, and he had the Stone Canyon Band. So when he came out, there was a great deal of mumbling and people whispering.
This booing started happening, and I thought, oh, yeah, I got to get out of here.
His whole life, all he had done was make people happy from the time he was a kid, you know? And here he was being booed off stage by a lot of people.
He sang Honky Tonk Woman, and that did it. People started stomping in those bleachers, and the noise just became deafening, where he just put his guitar down and walked off the stage.
You're 22,000 people booing you. It's a real frightening thing.
This was 1971. They wanted 1957. They didn't want 1971.
According to some accounts, Rick is later told he wasn't being booed, that what he heard was fans reacting to police activity in the garden.
He just sat there and thought about it, and he had a towel, and he was wiping himself off and stuff, and he just said that all he knew is he had to keep going, and he had to keep going in the direction that he was headed.
Rick Nelson's flop at Madison Square Garden might have ended his career. Instead, he'll make it a legendary chapter in rock and roll history. Headline.